Biafra. All hail Biafra. All hail Biafra. IPOB one family. IPOB one family. One family IPOB. That is what we are, and that is what we always be. Children of the Most High Chukwuka Biama. Good evening, good night, good morning, good afternoon from wherever you're joining us. My name remain your humble Chukwuemeka Anyaoru Okafor. Mazi Okafor is from Anyocha province in Biafra land, and I base here in Germany and serve the indigenous people of Biafra as the coordinator from the northern part of Germany. I greet each and every one of you. Before I start, I want to send a special greetings to our eternal leader, Dim Chukwuemeka Odumegwu Ojukwu, the man that sacrificed everything possible to make sure that people like me and you have the opportunity today to gather here to strategize and execute. The same greetings and praises goes to our supreme leader, Onyendu Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, who was brutally kidnapped in Kenya and renditioned to Nigeria, who, after all victories upon victories, the zoo contraption called Zoo Nigerian government, the terrorist Fulani hegemony are still holding hostages. We send greetings to him and we say, may Chukwuka Biama be with him. May he guide and protect him. May he be his strength there where he is, because we know latest by tomorrow that Elohim shall disgrace all his enemies. Greetings goes to the dust. The dust are wise. And the same greeting goes to the HOD, Mazi Chike Dozim, the head of the dust, a man filled with patience and wisdom, a man that Chukwuka Biama blessed and gave wisdom to lead his people in absence of our supreme leader, Onyendu Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. I say, may Chukwuka Biama bless you and continue to give you more wisdom to lead us until our leader is out to finish the job he started. Greetings goes to our host. I want to thank you for giving us the opportunity to be here today. As you are welcome here today, please endeavor to welcome your friends, even your enemy. Don't deny them the opportunity to be part of this march, to be part of this freedom speech, to be part of these victories that we're going to score. Before we start, I want to introduce the rules and regulations. Anybody that have a wish to speak should indicate, and as time goes in, I'm going to call you in and you will get 3 minutes to introduce yourself. But if you are in the contraption called Zoo Nigeria, we don't need your location. Your name is enough. But like as usual, before we go, we have to give honor and glories to our ancestors, the class of 1967, the men that sacrificed everything possible to make sure that we have the opportunity to live in this kingdom of God on earth that is called Motherland Biafra. Land of the rising sun we love and cherish, beloved homeland of our brave heroes. We must defend our life or we shall perish. We shall protect our hearts from all foes. But if the price is death for all we hold dear, Chukwuka Biama, please let us die without a shred of fear. And I continue, hail to Biafra, consecrated nation, O Fatherland, this be our solemn pledge. Defending thee shall be our dedication. Spilling our blood, we count a privilege. The waving standard which emboldens the free shall always be our flag of liberty. Thanks each and every one of you. I say, may Chukwuka Abiama bless you for taking out this time today to join us. And as you join in us, like as I've said before, feel free to welcome others. We have to intensify our diplomatic push to make sure that our leader, Onyedumba Nnamdi Kanu, is freed. Because as the appeal court, as you all know, have granted him freedom, the contraption cause Nigeria is still holding him. They are heading to appeal court. But children of the Most High, I have to tell you one thing. The more higher they go, the more deeper they fall. This is the case that they are going to face this time around. They should be ready to know and to accept defeat when they get to Supreme Court tomorrow. And they shouldn't forget that at that Supreme Court, we are going to negotiate Biafra also, not only the freedom of our leader, because this is what they called for. In case of those of you that does not know what is about to transpire tomorrow, I want you all to know exactly what is about to transpire tomorrow and then get used to it and be ready to face it when it happens. You know, because this is what is about to happen. Those of you that didn't understand what is happening to us, I don't know if you are aware, after the judgment on the 13th of October 2022 from the Supreme Court of Nigeria, after the judgment which discharged our leader Onyedumba Nnamdi Kanu from all the charges against him, the AGF, the Attorney General of the Contraption Cause Nigeria, came to live television to say that he need to consult the powers that need to be, including the Igbo leaders, before he can take the decision to free our leader, Onyedumba Nnamdi Kanu. And I want you all to know, or I want especially the so-called elites in Igbo land, the so-called Eastern governors, the so-called Eastern politicians, those that are not speaking up, that they should understand that the statement from the AGF is a direct indictment to them. It shows how complicit they are to what is happening to our leader. It shows how complicit they are to what is happening to our people. It shows how complicit they are to all the corruption going on in Biafra land. It shows how complicit they are to all the killings happening in Biafra land. It shows how complicit they are to all the raping, the ethnic cleansing, the genocide that is happening, massacre upon massacre. We jump from the massacre in Ihiala to the massacre in Obibo, to the massacre in Olu, to the massacre in Ogbaru, to the massacre in Ozuburu, to the massacre in Ebony, to the massacre in Enugu, one massacre after the other. So all these things that are happening with the statement of the AGF confirm what most of us have been suspicious about. The earlier they speak out, the earlier is the better for them, because we all know the consequence of them not speaking out. They should not forget the French Revolution. For those of you that are not familiar with it, they can go and check again. The French Revolution, when the masses got tired of their elites, they got rid of them and create a new society, a society based on equal right and justice. And that is the Biafra we are going to create. We are fighting to make sure we have a Biafra where equal right and justice is guaranteed for all citizens. Where the security and life and the properties of all citizens are guaranteed. We are fighting for a Biafra where free healthcare will be for all the citizens living within the territory of Biafra. We are fighting to restore a Biafra where free education shall be for every citizen living within our borders. We are fighting to restore a Biafra where steady water supply shall be for all our citizens. We are fighting for a Biafra where steady power supply shall be guaranteed in all our territory, because we have the resources, we have the technology and everything, we have the people. We are fighting for a Biafra where there will be secured social welfare for all our citizens, for everybody living in our society. We are fighting to make sure we restore a Biafra where the pension fund is guaranteed, where the corrupt politician will not have the opportunity to loot the funds that are meant to take care of our old citizens that have worked all their life to make sure that our society functions. We are fighting to restore a Biafra where the government shall provide support for the young entrepreneurs, for them to grow and create more jobs for our people. We are fighting for a Biafra where the government shall provide support for existing industries so that they can compete internationally with other big, big industries like BMW, Mercedes, Audi, Volkswagen, and some other ones that you all know that are very popular. We are fighting for a Biafra where the wish of common man is heard, not for only the money bags. We are fighting for a Biafra where the moral standards shall be set according to how hard you work and not how fast you can steal and loot the people's money. What we are talking about today is that the Eastern state politicians, the governors, their silence is a complete complicit of the things happening to our people. For the fact that they are not man enough to speak out after a whole appeal court have set one of their persons free, and they are all keeping mute for the sake of the charade 2023 selection, called election. This is a big shame. This is a big slap on the face. For how long shall we endure this? For how long are we going to watch while our heroes are being killed? I want to remind those generation, those youth that are 30 years and under. We, you guys, most of you should count yourself lucky that you still have the class of above 40. Those of us that witnessed when Biafra land was still a little bit holy. Those of us that witnessed where things were normal in Biafra land. That is why we are fighting to restore Biafra. That is why we are ready to sacrifice to make sure that we return to the olden days. We are an Igbo man. We are a Biafran man. It's respected all over the world. And we are going to make sure that we went back there, because that is what Chukwuka Biama wants from us. Our leader has a divine mandate. He didn't choose it, but he was selected to do it. And nothing shall happen to him until he has led his people home. I want to thank each and every one of you for being here today. But before I continue with the sermons we have today, I would like to call in Mazi Evans. Mazi Evans, are you there? Can you hear me, comrade?
Yes, Maz, I can hear you. Good evening.
Mazi, you are welcome. I can hear you loud and clear. Mechukwu Kabiama, bless you for taking out your time to join us today. Biafrans and freedom of lovers of freedom from all over the world are listening. The mic is yours.
Yeah, good evening, Maz. I still remember Maz Evans, half of my world, province of Biafra land. Maz, you know, if we don't do this, nobody will do it for us. That's why we must do this, Maz, because there's no other way. There's no other way out. According to Maz, they cannot see if we stop this race halfway, our people will continue dying, and all our children can no longer go home. And most of us will no longer go, not most of us, all of us can no longer go home. That's why we should not stop on a way. We must continue this race until the end, until Biafra is restored, Maz. I thank everybody listening to us, our listeners. We are here again to tell the world on how they are using needle on ourselves, on our face, on our faces, how Nigerian government are not only disobeying court orders, the Fulanis that is controlling the Nigerian government, they are trying to form Galadima. They are forming Buga because it is an Igbo man involved. The world has seen it now that it is not a case of not obeying court order. It's all about hate right now. It is hate. Many people who did not believe on Biafra restoration or Biafra project, they have come to realize sympathetically that this man called Nnamdi Kanu is being held now based on hate. If not, why shouldn't the Nigerian government controlled by Fulani obey court order, which is their own court, judged and ruled by their own judges, in which they themselves nominated, appointed? Tell me the reason why a country saying that they are running into democracy cannot obey the rule of law. Tell me the reason why. There is no justification on what they are doing to Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Nigeria has nothing. They have tried every means they can or they could to make sure that they find something standing to nail him, but they couldn't find. That was the reason why, and that is the reason why we are still protecting every avenue or avenues in which Nigerian government will have anything to hold Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. We try to educate our people on ground, both on how they will behave, so that these people will not see anything to lay on their finger against our leader. That is the reason why we don't want any nonsense from any chapter, anybody. If you know that you are the person that caused the problem, you come out and say, it is me that did this, not IPOB. Because they have done everything to harm this man. They have done everything. They have every avenue. They have run out of plan. Because it is said that whenever you plan without God, that plan, you must plan it again. Because God is with Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, and he has shown in every angle and ramification that he is with him. Concerning our political class, the people from that region, where this manner of injustice is being meted on their son, man, you have to remember that it is still the same people that called together and sold their Joseph, which is their brother, in the name of 2023 election presidency. What is happening today? Fulani promised them 2023 Igbo presidency. Kucho America told them it can never, it is dead on arrival. They can dream for 300,000 years, it can never come to pass. What happened today? The Fulani denied them what they planned for them to reduce Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. The Fulani told them, we cannot give it to you. Go and do your worst. You have given us what you want by selling Nnamdi Kanu to us. So they are all ashamed. As I'm talking to you now, Mazi, those are politicians and our political allies from that our region, and some Christian leaders. Mazi, I'm telling you right now, they don't know their next plan. All of them are no longer sleeping because they know anything can happen right now, starting from tomorrow. If the zoo happen to bribe whatever they call, try to convince anybody tomorrow to judge against what the appeal court earlier judged on the 13th of this month, Mazi, I'm telling you, it's no longer be as usual. Nobody is going to sleep anymore, because that is the reason why you are seeing them after meeting Malami. They discuss whatever they discuss at the back of the door. When they come at the social media, they say, we ask Nigerian government, federal government, please to obey court order. Release Nnamdi Kanu now. Of course, you know, at the backyard, under the table, behind the door, this is not what you told Buhari and Malami. You people told him to still hold him. I don't know why these people think that we are fools. Are we fools? IPOB, we are not fools. We are seven steps ahead of them. Because as far as they are planning, we know when they want to plan, we know what they are planning, and we know exactly what they planned, and when they started the meeting, and when they finished it, and the agenda of the meeting. They cannot go and say, don't release this guy, you. If not, we are not sure of ourselves anymore. They come on the social media and say, release that guy, obey court order. For the sake of, I have said it. Maasi, Nigeria government should understand, as far as tomorrow is concerned, the countdown has started. We are waiting, we are listening, and we are watching. Not only that we are watching, we are following them step to step in any way they want to follow it. We are diplomatically there, we are spiritually there, we are physically there. Maasi, we are socially everywhere on this case that they can never jail our leader. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Maasi. My comrade, Mechukwu Okabiama, bless you. May he give you more wisdom, you know, and good health also. You see, Maasi, just like our leader used to say, in one of his last broadcasts, in his prayer, he said boldly, he made it for a deaf man to even hear. He said, Elohim, please, may I can see Habahono. And today, what they are facing, it's like the dog has swallowed a bone that is hanging on his throat. He cannot pull it down and he cannot spit it out. This is exactly what is happening to them. The corner where they are today, they are being pushed on the corner. And the only solution for them is to let Biafra go. Not just our leader, because they are, for going to that Supreme Court, they have put themselves on a corner. They have put our leader on the book of history. Because whatever decision that happens tomorrow in that Supreme Court shall be history. It shall be a reference to whatever case that will happen, not just only in that contraption called Zoo, but in motherland Africa and the worldwide. One thing I want our Eastern politicians to know is that, you see, in this journey, in this fight to restore the Holy Land of Biafra, the kingdom of God on earth, we shall never lose, because whatever Chukwu Okabiama has ordained shall come to pass. Our leader, all his prophecies, right from start, all his prophecies has come to pass. So there is nothing they can do against it. So this particular Biafra restoration, to restore Biafra land, it shall also come to pass, and there is nothing any human being can do against it. This is something they must know. And one thing I want to remind them, our people, there is a proverb, there is an Igbo adage that said, Chuwakwe Uoji Mbwe Ihedi, because Chijie, Ewoji, Eji Uoji Kachi, and then Ilu Zukwana. This is my simple advice to most of them, because apart from elder statesman Dan Olansi that came out openly and voiced his anger with emotion about what they're doing to us, the other ones are doing eye service. And some of them are speaking just for the fact to say they are speaking. And those that are still hiding, waiting to see that our leader is released or that the table turn before they will change sides, I want to advise them, don't let it be too late for you, because we are keeping records. What is dying is human being. We are keeping records. Those families that are dying, those families that their mothers, their fathers, their children that are dying, those Biafrans that are dying, belong to somebody. And we are keeping records, Hope Uzodimba. We are keeping records, Dave Umahi. We are keeping records, Ofa Efani Ugwani. We are keeping records, Charles Soludo. I want to remind all of you, it's not long ago, the frog from Liverine that is always talking when he's talking, that refused to accept, that doesn't even know his heritage, that doesn't know which tribe he belongs, because of the love for money and because of he want to serve the Fulani hegemony. What is happening to him now? His frustration, his close ace are saying through the back doors that if he had known that those, the Tambowal, his partner, his sesco and all these things, if he had known that those people would deceive him and fuck him up and down, that he would have not dare keep people at Obibo. And still, some of these stupid Eastern region politicians, they cannot learn from what happened to that guy called Nwiki. I just don't want to put his name on his mouth, because it will be about giving him attention that he doesn't deserve. He's now crying up and down, running up and down. They flooded his area. It was a deliberate flood that our people are suffering. They did it purposely to punish that guy. The same people he was collaborating with to mess our people up, the same people he was collaborating with to kill his own people, have now flooded all our liver line area just to punish him because they see he's trying to give them headache. And still, our greedy politicians fail to learn. We are seeing what is transpiring. Those our comrades from the western part of that contraption called Zoo, Nigeria, the Oduduwa Nation's fighters, and some people from Middle Belt, they are speaking out boldly, saying that what is being peddled to our leader is pure injustice. Some of them are even pushing threat towards the contraption called Zoo Terrorist Fulani government, telling them you can't do this. That once appeal court have taken a decision, they have decided on something, that instance, telling them, oh, you want to learn the law from us. And now I start asking myself, does that mean we doesn't have politicians of the same caliber that are speaking up from the western part of this thing? These greedy animals, do they think they will live forever? I'm asking the eastern state politicians, these greedy animals, do they think they will live forever? Only God knows which pact they have crossed with the Fulani hegemony that they are afraid to speak out. But one advice I will give them, man up yourself and speak out, because a wise man only die once and not twice. A coward will die 1,000 times. And you, the consequence of you as Eastern politician failing to talk is that your enemy will see it as a weakness towards you. That the Fulanis are afraid of our leader is because they know his light. They know he's the truth. They know he's the way and he's the forward. And that's why all of them are afraid of him. They know that he has defeated them and defeated death, and nothing any of them can do to him. And let me let them understand, they shouldn't take our silence for fools, because it's not that we don't know what to do. If anything happens to our leader, we've told the European communities, we've told the European government, we've told the European Union, the Western European colonies, we've made them understand, if anything happens to our leader, you guys are having problem with the Russians already. Your energy sectors are falling. Your industries are crumbling. And if you think you're going to get anything out of Biafra land when anything happens to our leaders, then you should be ready to terminate the life of 80 million Biafrans. Because both the ones that are born today will be ready to crawl. Both the ones that are lying on the baby bed, Biafrans that are lying on the baby bed, will be ready to crawl to make sure that nothing is taken out of our land. If anything happens to our leader, it is not a threat, but it's a promise. A promise made with the blood of more than 80 million people you people have killed in the last years. And that we shall never forget. The fight continues. We move. Before I continue, I would like to call him Mazi Kemba. Mazi Kemba, can you hear me? Yes, Mazi, your voice is a little bit down. Maybe you're a little bit far from the machine you're using. Maybe you can come a little bit close so that all our listeners can hear you. You are welcome. You are an old colleague and comrade of all. Mesuko Kabiama, bless you. The mic is yours.
Okay. I'm sorry to be because I'm under the weather, so I don't have to mess up. Good evening, brothers and sisters. Mazi Kemba.
Mazi, can you hear me? Yeah, because it's like where you are is noisy. Your voice is not coming out completely clear. So I don't know if all our listeners can hear you. You know, so maybe if it's because of network or you are in a location where it's not so clear, maybe you should just change location and then you can join us. Or can you hear me now better? Can you speak? Let me confirm,
please. I can hear you clearly.
Yeah. Yes, now your voice is coming out clearly. Now you can continue, Maz. The mic is yours.
Okay. Good evening, lovers of freedom, Biafrans. Special greetings to the host and to you, Maz Chukwu Emeka. I want to use this opportunity to thank everyone of us here for the time, for making our time every 7 o'clock to be here, in a time like this, spacing up, making a space of time to listen, to join this space, it's not easy. So let me dive into the topic of today. We already know that the Zulu government are just a government who want to build their own court. So we have already foreseen this to come. And that's why I don't know if I don't want, I'm a realistic guy. I don't want to put it if you have spiritual eye or if you have anime more, no. But if you look at the direct point of being realistic, you will know that this is Elohim at work. Because tomorrow will be a day that the word Biafra will mention on the Supreme Court. Tomorrow will be a day that the zoo will be divided more than four times. So I love the way this is going. I'm telling you the fact. I love the way this is going because even though the Britain or the so-called European, the Westerners who claim they are for democrats, who can't speak up for an injustice, even when the rule of court have ordered the government to release Nnamdi Kanu, but they still withheld him. That's to tell the hypocrisy of these guys. So I don't have much to say. I'll just say tomorrow is a big day for us. Tomorrow is a big day for us. So I want to use this opportunity, to encourage everyone of us. It have not been easy. I myself, I'm under the weather. That's why I'm feeling. That's why I'm like this. So I want to encourage everyone of us. Be strong. The judges, if you're a student of Nnamdi Kanu, said that he'll be leading. He will be leading from the front. And where is he leading from? From the DSS custody. So tomorrow is a big day, and I believe and I pray victory will be ours. Thank you very much, Mazi.
Thank you very much, Mazi Kemba. May Chukwu Kabiama bless you. May he continue to give you more wisdom, and may he give you good health. He say, we must continue. You see, I'm always, sometimes I wonder about the generation we have now, the youth we have currently in that contraption called Zoo Nigeria. I was watching this, Pastor Oyedepo the other day, the statement he was making, reading it loud in front of his congregation, that the Buhari, that people are calling Buhari, is already dead. That the man that is there in Aso Rock is Jubri. He was explaining how his families from Niger came to demand something from Nigerian government. 50% of our oil revenues and different kind of things. And people cannot take 1+1. You saw a man that is not even up to 40 years, claiming to be the old Buhari, jumping up and down, climbing the step of this thing. But the person that is his age mate, the Tifnubu of Lagos that is campaigning, can hardly climb a step alone. So I don't know where the sense of, you see, what these politicians have did to our youth. Most of them cannot think. All their concentration our concentration is about BB Niger or this or Manchester or this or Chelsea, and this is just all they could argue about. And then the most gullible ones are thinking of the 2023 charade court election that is coming up. I don't know who did this to the African youth, more especially Nigerian youth. I don't know who did it to them. I don't know how far we've fallen. We must continue. Tomorrow is going to be a very great and a very wonderful day. Tomorrow, the wind shall blow and we shall see the ass of the chicken. Tomorrow, those people that thought that they could jail our leader, they will stand and face the reality that they cannot do anything to our leader, because the international communities have had enough. Most of them that are following the what is transpiring in Nigeria, most of them that are receiving the correspondence steady, both the United Nations that is partly silent, there are still some people there that are working hard following this case. That's why they could deliver judgment some months ago to Nigerian government, giving them instruction or advice on what to do. The Nigerian courts, more especially the Supreme Court, knows that the satellite of the world through the indigenous people of Biafra is shining on them. That is the pressure from outside that even make the appeal court took that bold decision, because they know failing to do that, to do the right thing, there will be a caricature in front of the world. That contraption called Zoo, just like as our leader told them that by the time he finished with them, Somalia will be better than them, they are getting to the abyss. Step by step, they are heading to destruction, thinking that they want to deal with our leader, Onyedum Azin Nnamdi Kanu, not knowing that they are dealing with themselves. Because at the end of the day, we shall be jumping from one victory to the other, and there is nothing any of them can do about it. Those I'm pitying, and those I will repeat calling out, are the Eastern politicians, those Eastern governors, those that have the responsibility to care for Biafrans, those that are sitting in the seat of power in that contraption called Zoo Nigeria, the senators, the House of Reps, the governors, the commissioners, the ministers, the local government chairman. This is the clock is ticking. This is your opportunity to speak out. If you fail to use this opportunity to speak out, we have it on our record that you are working with our enemy. This will not be a kind of somebody saying, okay, we don't know, or trying to specify or think or something like that. It will be a direct indictment. It will be a confirmation that what the AGF said about you people is true. We shall confirm that it is through you guys that our leader is still sitting illegally in detention after the court have freed him. So we are calling you guys out to act, to speak with one voice, to issue a statement to Nigerian government, to that Fulani terrorist government, and make them understand that withholding the leader of indigenous people of Biafra, the leader of 80 million population, that they are sitting on a time bomb. That the earlier they let him free as a free man and start negotiating with him, the better for all mankind. And this is what we have to tell them. Before I continue, I will call on Mazi Chidera Emmanuel. Mazi Chidera Emmanuel, can you hear me? Mazi Chidera Emmanuel, can you hear me? Okay, it's like the Mazi is far from his this thing. He's far from his machine. Let me call on Mazi Antidox. Mazi, can you hear me? Because you were there before. I don't know what happened to you. Mazi John. Mazi John, can you hear me?
Yeah, good evening.
Mazi, you are welcome. Mechukwu Okabiama bless you and give you more wisdom. It's like you're joining us for the first time. Please, a short introduction. If you are not from, If you are within the location of Biafra land or that contraption called zoo, you don't need to tell us your location. Your name is enough. But if not, we will welcome. Okay. Thanks very much. The mic is yours.
Okay, thank you very much. Oh, hey, Biafra.
My name
is Anitochi or Anitochuku John, but I am known by Biafran Justice. So I just have a little thing to say. What I know is that the court has already given their verdict. So the Nigerian government just need to release him first before the appeal court. Even if they are going to the appeal court will still settle on that judgment. They will not go far from that place. They need to release him. That is what they should do. Regards to our leaders, I want us to understand that we have no leaders in the Southeast. We have no leaders. Most especially, we don't have elders anymore. We have elders that are focused in building their pockets. Selfish and self-centered men that are supposed to be dead. Those people are not supposed to be our leaders. We're not supposed to even be calling them our leaders. Because if you can't come out to stand for your children, or come out, look at the Yoruba people. When they arrested this guy, Ibohu, what did they call him? They fought for him. They went to visit him in Benin. They fought, they speak out. But now it's concerning our leader now. Nobody wants to talk. Knowing the truth that this man is innocent of anything, he's fighting for justice of his people. But nobody wants to speak. Nobody wants to say anything. But what I know is that God is with him. Joshua is with him. And they can never defeat a man who is fighting for justice. Thank you very much, and God bless you.
Thank you very much, Mazi Anitochi Mechukwu Kabiama. Bless you. You know, you see your name, Anitochukwu. You see, I always cherish it when our people remember our heritage and when our people are proud with the name given to them by our ancestors, because we are our ancestors. Most of us, please, I will beg Mazi this thing, Mazi Nzube Chukwu, to stay mute. Every other person that I've indicated to speak here, as time goes on, I'm going to call you in. But before then, make sure that your microphone is on silent, on mute. Normally, this is a one-hour program, but those that are given the opportunity that have accepted their request, I will make sure that they get their 3 minutes to express themselves. So, and every other person failing to off your mic and you talk, you might give me a reason to take you out as a speaker, because you're disturbing the message, the gospel that we came here to do today. You understand? So this is, you are all welcome to Biafran Twitter space. And what we do here is we strategize and execute. This is not kindred meeting. This is not the gathering of Umunna. What we do here is freedom fighting. We are here to liberate our people. We are here to liberate the indigenous population that are trapped in that contraption called Zoo Nigeria. And we shall not stop until we get there, because this is our mission. This is a mandate given to our leader, Onyedumazi Nnamdi Kanu, and we are his followers. We are his humble followers, and we are going to support him by every means possible to make sure that the kingdom of God, the kingdom of Chukwu Kabiam on this mother earth, Biafran land, is restored, whether the mankind like it or not, and nothing is going to stop us. You see, Mazi, what is transpiring right now in that contraption called Zoo Nigeria has been prophesied by our leader in his last broadcast while he was on question and answers section. A caller asked him, our leader, after complaining, when are we going to start our this or our that? Our leader made it clear to them that the fight to liberate our motherland is going to start, and when it starts, that he will be leading from the front. And he said at the end of that speech, and one thing is clear, I will never disappoint my people. I will never disappoint my people, but my fear is that my people might disappoint me. So I'm looking at most of you that are calling themselves obituaries this and obituaries that. They are forgetting that our leader is still incarcerated, detained illegally in that contraption called Zoo Nigeria, detained illegally by DSS against the judgment of appeal court. It is time for most of you to wake up and know that the injustice peddled against our leader is an injustice peddled to every Biafran. And it doesn't matter if you're from Ebony. It doesn't matter if you're from Akwa Ibom. It doesn't matter if you're from Igwacha. It doesn't matter if you're from Omambala. It doesn't matter wherever you are from. It doesn't matter if you're from Obaru or if you're from Abo. As long as you live and come from that eastern region, you remain an inyamri to these Fulani Janjawis that are killing our people. And the day the Adaga will catch your throat, they will feel happy that they've sliced the throat of an infidel, of an inyamri, of somebody that doesn't know God, knowing fully well that we are the children of the Most High. So I call on all of you to be vigilant, to be steadfast. And those of you that understand the system we are should make sure you spread enough awareness to prepare our people, because tomorrow, whatever the Supreme Court decides shall be in our favor, whether they like it or not, because their hands are tied behind their back. They cannot listen to the Janjaweed because they will make fool out of themselves to decide any other things. We know the structure of law. We know the rule of law, how it goes. So, and those that are speaking out mostly are those from the western part of that contraption called Zoo Nigeria. That's why we keep asking. We are our so-called Igbo allies. Where is our so-called Eastern politician, apart from Dadan Olanse that spoke the other day? Most of them are still keeping mute and silent. Before we continue, I will call on Mazi Ebube. Mazi Ebube, can you hear me? Are you there?
I'm here.
Okay, Mazi, you are welcome to Biafran Twitter Space. I think you are joining us for the first time.
I'm not joining for the first time.
Okay, you're not joining for the first time, then it should be sorry from my side, but still a short introduction is welcome. The mic is yours.
Good evening, everyone, and all here, Biafra. This evening, though, anyway, where I'm talking from, I'm not in Nigeria, though. I'm talking from Ghana. So, but this movement, I'm encouraging everybody to stand firm, because we are almost at the end part of this movement. We are almost, we are almost there to achieve our goal. We are not going to stop now. I'm just saying this to motivate everybody. I'm just saying this so that every one of us will not look back, no matter what. Everybody needs to stand. Because I could remember what the atrocities the Israelites passed through in the hands of Hitler. None of them give up. None of them gave up. None of them. They still stand firm and make the strategic plans that they did that made them got what they are today. So I'm encouraging everybody, no matter how small, how big you can create your own awareness, do it. Don't look back, because I know by next year, everything will be okay. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mazi. May Chukwu Okabiama bless you and continue to give you wisdom. You see, this is exactly what we're talking about. Our people has to be on guard. Our people has to be ready to face whatever that is about to come, because we know that victory is ours. It is a promise from Chukwuka Abiama that victory shall be ours. Our leader have said it many times, and this is what we are seeing transpiring in front of our eyes. So there is no denial of it that the victory is assured. So we are ready, and we are ever ready to take the bull by the horn. May Chukwuka Abiama bless you. Before we continue, I want to call on Mazi Kitipa. Mazi, can you hear me, please, comrade?
Yes, I can hear you.
Mazi, may Chukwuka Abiama bless you. You are old listener of our forum. I say may he give you strength and more wisdom. The mic is yours.
Dalo Mazi Chukwuka Abiama. And I extend my greetings to Biafran Twitter for always hosting this space. Most of the time I miss out on them due to my activities, but I always find a way to listen to the recordings and stuff. Umunem, Biafrans in diaspora and Biafrans in Biafraland, I greet all of you, and the ones in Biafra land, I'm using this medium to tell you that the persecution will soon be over. And the ones in diaspora, very soon we will go home by the grace of Chukwuka Abiama. It will happen. Yeah, I was reading on the news of how the Supreme Court judges who were on the panels were transferred. You know, even if, let's just say, the federal government dismantles their legal system, the judiciary and everything, and assemble new one, even a Bushman give a judgment based on the natural order of things that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is innocent and will continue to be innocent, because this is a spiritual mandate and this is a spiritual mission that he has taken up for himself. Umunem, Please amplify your voice. This is the time. This is the time. It gets the hardest when it's about to get very easy. That is very true. Amplify your voice. Tell it to the world that Onyendu is still incarcerated. Even though we know that he has no case to answer, even though we know that he is illegally in Nigeria, even though we know that his trial, it's that of error, it's that of persecution, he still won them in their court. And he will continue to win them. Amplify your voice anywhere you are. Call them out. Call this evil contraption out. Call this evil presidency out. Let the world know of what is happening in Nigeria, how Onyendu is being held against his will, and his human rights is being tampered with. Please, amplify your voice. That is, if you think whatever you do here, whatever you say here, whatever you write on social media, do not contribute to the struggle, I will tell you that you are mistaken. If not for each and every one of us, Onyendu would have undergone a secret trial and jailed. If not for each and every one of us who spoke up, who alerted the international community, who alerted everybody, who alerted the lovers of freedom, Onyendu would have undergone a secret trial and secret witnesses would have been brought and Onyendu would have been jailed. But thank God to each and every one of us who contributed, who spoke up when this chariot was about to be carried out. If we did it last time, we could do it this time again. Amplify your voice. Let them know that we know and we stand behind our leader. I yield the mic for now. Thank you, Mazi Chukwuemeka Anyora.
Thank you very much, Mazi. May Chukwuemeka Anyora bless you and give you more wisdom. You see, from your word, we can draw a lot of conclusion, because why I'm saying this, for those of you that are not familiar with the legal terms, this case against our leader, most hardcore IPOB members, family members, because I always say, everybody from Eastern region is a Biafran, but it's not everybody that is IPOB family members. Take it or leave it. This is just the fact. And most of us knows that the day they brutally kidnap our leader and rendition it, that all their case against him is dead on arrival, because we know it is against international norm. We know that the Western world, if they dare risk it, what is going on between them and Russia, Russia will use it and run home against them, that they cannot even maintain the law they created. And that is a fact, because you cannot go to another man's house and kidnap somebody that is not your citizen, bring him to your country and try it. And that is the pronouncement coming out from the appeal court. You cannot go and kidnap an international citizen that is not a Nigerian citizen and try it, because for kidnapping Nnamdi Kanu, you've lost all the rights of trial to him. And no court in that contraption called Zoo Nigeria has court in that contraption called Zoo Nigeria has the right to try our leader Onyedumba Azinna and the Kanu. That is just the fact. And they've stated it clean and clear. So that's why these people, the AGF Malami and his co, moving to Supreme Court, they're just going to make a mess out of themselves. They will look like some dump ass in front of Supreme Court, because those judges there have more to lose to deliver, to try to turn the decision, the judgment of appeal court. They will end up in Hague. They will be tried internationally, and they all know what they're going to face. This is just a fact, because they all swore an oath internationally to defend the law, the international law. And that is what we all know. Before we continue, I would like to call him Mazi Lion Man. And I want to remind every other speaker that have not called in to have patience, that as long as I've permitted you to speak, you will still get your time to speak. Mazi Lion Man, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Mazi, you are welcome. Chukwuemeka Anyora bless you and give you more wisdom. The mic is yours.
You say.
Why?
Mazi, I thank you so much for your effort on this Twitter to pass this message to the world. And first of all, I want to greet all Biafrans around the world and thank Chukwuemeka Anyora for this wonderful victory that Chukwuemeka Anyora have given to us through the appeal court of the Nigerian state. Mazi, the issue of our leader being still in the detection of DSS after the pronouncement of appeal court that pronounced our leader discharged and acquitted. I think one thing is playing out here is that, you know, what somebody was telling me, I said, no, the judge in appeal court that discharged our leader and acquitted our leader did exactly what stated on constitution, both internationally and locally, because you cannot boycott what I call a process of extradition, which is Nigeria did not follow the process. And they went ahead and breached all the laws that concerned that particular article. So that is the area they mess up themselves. And the continuation of them trying to play stubborn concerning the pronouncement of a appeal court is laughable. It's laughable. You see, when I look at the Attorney General of Nigeria saying, make a statement that the Igbo elders and the Igbo elite and the politicians are the ones that the freedom of Nnamdi Kanu is in their hands. It shows that that guy did not pass through law school. You see, the appointment of this Malami should be reviewed and it should be investigated properly, because Constitution is supreme more than any figure or any individual. It's laughable to hear such from a man who occupies such position that's supposed to be a well-learned man, because his office is simply means a advisor. Attorney General stands as an advisor to the law. But now that the person who they appointed as an advisor to the law of the nation is, maybe he doesn't even understand what it means to dispense justice. That means he need to be questioned. His position need to be questioned by the Nigerian Bar Association. They need to come together and investigate his position, because it's laughable. It looks ridiculous to me, because I have been contemplating on this issue. I say, for an attorney general to make mention of individual or group of people, present them as people who are barrier to constitution, it shows that there is doom in that country. There is completely doom in that nation. So what I'm here to contribute is this. I strongly believe tomorrow is the hearing for the appeal, according to them. We are looking forward tomorrow to see what they are going to act in that so-called appeal, because one, his appeal is supposed to be thrown away. It's not supposed to be entertained. But I am looking forward to see if there is any judge that will entertain that appeal. Then then the world will know that we don't tolerate nonsense. So, my brother, I thank you once again, and I thank everyone who have been in the front line of this particular journey to make sure that our leader is safe and return back to his position. Thank you very much. God bless you.
Thank you very much, Mazi. May Chukwu Kabiama bless you, and may he give you long life and good health, you know, and happiness on top of it for your wonderful word. Fellow Biafrans, I want to thank each and every one of you for having patience with us today, for being here with us today, for bringing out your precious time. Because I always say, most of the people back home does not know the worth of time like the way we know it here. We know that every minute you spend somewhere worth a pound of gold. Before I continue, let me call in Mazichi Biafra. Mazi, are you there? Can you hear me? Mazichi Biafra, can you hear me, Mazi? It's like the Mazi is not there. Mazi Hejirika, can you hear me? Hejirikamba. Oziomachi, can you hear me?
Yes, Mazi, yes, I can hear you.
You are welcome to Biafran Twitter space. May Chukwu Kabiama bless you. Can you give us a short introduction? And if you are in the vicinity of that contraption called Zoo Nigeria, you don't need to tell us your location. We are good with your name. The mic is yours, please.
Okay, I greet you all. Please, am I coming out loud?
You are coming out loud and clear, Mazi. Continue.
Okay, I greet you all, the great people of Biafra, IPOP. We are whiter than white. I'm very, very happy to be among you people, because it is my first time of joining this Twitter space. I say, may Almighty Chukwu Okike Abiama be with you all. We are the largest mass movement on this planet Earth. We are the ancient people, the oldest race on this planet Earth. So we don't need to be afraid. I encourage each and every one of us to be strong and to be formidable, because we are almost there. Because, you know, Biafra has been restored. If you look into the future, you will see that the future is bright, that Biafra has already come. The Nigerian government, they must release our leader, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. But you know, they are so much afraid. You know, the reason why they are afraid is because they know that the release of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is going to bring the total obliteration of Nigeria from the surface of the earth. So we should not be afraid. Victory is yours. Tomorrow's courts, we shall receive victory. We shall receive victory. We shall receive victory. So I greet each and every one of you to remain strong and formidable, that we are whiter than white. I greet you all. I greet you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mazi. Thanks very much for your wonderful word. We shall remain formidable, whiter than white and whiter than snow. That is what we are. Our leader taught us discipline, and with that discipline, we are going to fall our enemies. What they were expecting to happen after they brutally kidnapped our leader from Kenya and renditioned him to Nigeria did not happen. They didn't know that we have the doors. The doors are very wise. The doors are very, very wise. Under the leadership of Mazi Dozie and the brave heart Chinua Sanwo-Olu, they thought that after kidnapping our leader, just like the way a hawk will take a chicken and then the children will scatter. That was what they thought. After planting many infiltrators among us, they thought that they can destroy our structure. They didn't understand what our leader was saying from beginning, that the structure of this hollow movement, IPOB that he leads, that it will take mankind more than 1,000 years to destroy. And after we've come and gone, the masses shall be begging for more of us to come, but we shall not be there because we've done our job and we are good. We are at the closing hour of this, our struggle. Tomorrow shall be very decisive, because after the judgment from the Supreme Court, we are expecting them to take their decision within highest three sittings. But if by the grace of Chukwuka Abiama, they shall be able to decide tomorrow, because our leader had no case to answer. And we shall, the whole satellite of this earth is pointed towards them. There is no chance for them to cheat or try to turn the judgment, because evil is evil, and we shall continue to call it out. Extraordinary rendition is an international crime under the Charter of the United Nations. And this is a crime the Nigerian terrorist government have committed against our leader. And there is no court. There is no court in that contraption called Zoo Nigeria that would decide otherwise. Before I continue, I want to call in Mazi, living witness. Mazi, can you hear me? Are you there, Mazi?
I can hear you loud and clear, sir.
Okay, Mazi, it's like you're a new speaker. Please, can you introduce yourself if you're within the vicinity of that contraption called Zoo Nigeria? We don't need your location.
Mbanom na London. My name is Onyekachukwu. From Onri, the ancestral home of the Igbos. I'm in London at the moment, anyway. So I'm very happy to be in this forum at this moment, you know, because by the grace of God, I'm a legal practitioner called to the Nigerian bar and what have you. And, you know, I've been following the suits up and down to see how things are unfolding and how things are going. When he went to the appeal court, I wasn't expecting anything other than what happened, you know. And the judgment of the court, from the judgment of the court, they said the Malami, you know, Kota San, because under normal circumstances, there is no how Malami should be a senior advocate of Nigeria. But because of Kota Imago Kahasemi, they will come and say, okay, these people, let's make sure that there is true federalism. So they gave him. And he's now saying that our leader was discharged and not acquitted. Quite all right. It means that if you are not acquitted, that means you can still be brought to another court. That's a higher court. But when you are acquitted, that means no charge at all. So I don't know why the appeal court maybe was misled, or maybe it was, I don't know. So they left it open so that maybe they can try the Supreme Court as well. So, but the thing, the problem now is the federal government are supposed to obey the decision. Let me quote the case of FGN versus ASU. Remember, ASU wanted to go to the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court struck out the case and told them, go and adhere with the decision of the lower court first. Because the appellate court has given an order which you have to obey. That was when ASU said, okay, we have to go back to school and then we'll go into another strike. But you have to obey the order first. So I'm not even scared. You know, I'm just praying that let it not be that the executive have hijacked the institution of the judiciary to their own, you know, to persecute people they want to persecute. I just hope that the judiciary is still independent and they are still ready to uphold justice as they swore to do. You know, so I'm not expecting anything less than or more than what was given at the appellate court. So had Gago do it to the Supreme Court, definitely the Supreme Court will strike out if they are still on justice. You know, if they are still upholding justice, they will strike it out immediately. And even as a matter of fact, they might even give any order to the federal government, because that is there is what we call it in law. We say there is something we call it, like it's like insulting the court. You know, this is a futile case. It is a case that it's dead on arrival. It cannot hold. It's just like, you know, it's just like bringing a case in front of a court that does not have jurisdiction. That case will be struck out, you know. So that is what I'm hoping and expecting that will happen tomorrow at the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court is supposed to strike it out immediately and even acquit and discharge and acquit them if they are still upholding justice. But if they have been hijacked the way they were hijacked when they removed the governor of Imo State and put Hope Uzodinma, well, I have nothing to say, because even in our law, there is no way someone who took fault can become a governor. Even if the first person couldn't make it, the second person should be there. You know, so, but, you know, Buhari is just doing anything he likes just to, you know, to intimidate. And because all manner many secrets in Haji, there is no way. Don't be surprised. Even when the Supreme Court will acquit him or discharge him, they will still not release him. Don't be surprised. But I believe that at that point, the international community, hopefully, we now have the necessary grounds, because the reason they didn't put mouth so much when the appellate court, because there is still an option for them to go to the higher court. But from the outcome of what will happen tomorrow, we will now know whether the international community will sanction Malami. And there is no way Buhari and Malami will not face international criminal court for what they did. Extraordinary rendition is not something ordinary that you can just play with. You flawed international laws and even your local laws. So this is it. So, but we are just prayerful. I've been telling my friends and everybody should be prayerful. Let it just be that the Supreme Court is still upholding justice. Onyedikachi, I'm yielding the mic.
Thank you very much, Maazi Onyedikachi. May Chukwu Okabiama bless you for the wonderful word and wisdom. May he continue to give you good health and happiness. You see, it's just like what we are saying. Extraordinary rendition is a big crime. And one thing that is assured is that the world order at the moment is in Dango. The world order. The Western world, the Americans, the Britain, the Germans, all these Western powers, they are really under pressure from Russia, because Russia is telling us, the third world, is telling everybody that the status quo are holding us all in bondage, that they are playing masters and we are their keys. that they are just interpreting the law when it favors them and not. So this case of our leader Onyeduma Azinandekara, that's why we that know him, Kamo Zuzu, we that knows our leader, those that knows him, we knows that he's not just an ordinary being, because he's a man with a mandate on this mission. All he has said keep transpiring in front of our eyes. He said that Britain will have problems. He said that the world will have problems. Are we not seeing it right now? Are we not hearing the news coming out of London? Are we not seeing the blackout happening in London for the first time after so many years? We are witnessing things transpiring in our hands, things that are beyond the understanding of most of the gullible ones. These are what we are seeing. But we shall continue. One thing is clear, is that those judges at the Supreme Court, I believe most of them are very educated, and they know what happened to the German Nazi judges at the Nuremberg Tribunal. Those judges that choose the side of the Nazis and were jailing and killing innocent people, abetting the crime of the Nazi regime. At the end of the day, they all faced trials, and most of them were executed. And the same destinies await any judge in this particular case of our leader that will try to decide otherwise. It is not ordinary that Binta Nyaku the whole time was just jumping, because she knows deciding otherwise will be very fatal for her and all her families. We shall continue. Before we move on, I would like to give Mazi Cartoon, he called himself. I don't know your real name. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, Mazi, can you just give us a short introduction if you are within the vicinity of that contraption called Zoo, Nigeria? Your location is not important. The mic is yours. You can continue.
Omo Biafra Kalemono. Oga dere no ma na eke na ori na nko na afọ umu defali na gbonbo no wali na ka dere no na ma. Yeah, my name is Obidigbo. Thank you for this opportunity to communicate over here. I've been listening to what you people have been contributing in one way or the other. I'm very far from the contraption they call themselves. I'm in America. I want to beg everybody, even in Freetown, nothing is free. We must not give up. It's going to be the last thing any Biafra man will ever do. The only thing I want to contribute here is this. Even if, no matter the law to pass tomorrow, no matter the judgment, nobody should fear. Because already, if you remember, as of the month of June, the United Nations already sent a message down to the people of Nigeria, their government, concerning our leader, MAK. So nobody, even no matter what the judgment they try to pass there, nobody should be afraid. We'll still wait for them at the international court. So even if Malami try, bring the best of the Supreme lead, Court to pass his judgment, nobody should panic. We'll still wait for them. Before election, the judgment of United Nations will still come up, because they say they gave the Nigerian government 6 months. So I make sure I follow their meetings one after the other. But the only thing I would like to beg our people in this space is this. And we are so much in this space. I can see lots of Biafra, lots of Igbo people in this space. The only thing I'll try to beg you tonight, if there's any information you can bring out to share, any information to pass it down to you, even to United Nations, anybody that knows anything about law, even in Twitter space, let us trend tonight before 24 hours tomorrow. It's going to go a long way. We don't have to give up. So I don't have to make so much contribution so that I'll give other people a chance to talk. But I want to beg every Igbo person here, no matter the judgment of the Supreme Court, even though let them sentence, no matter the level of the high quotation they want to bring, nobody should panic. The United Nations is there. We've seen their documents. I've already taken time to read some of the documents. So don't try to panic. And I want to beg, I prefer, I want my life, I want the creative space right now, see buying. I will try to use this opportunity to beg every person here. The only play way we can liberate our people through, again, is through history. Yeah, history is going to be the best way we can liberate our people. because this journey is not going to end here. Even if MAK comes out, we don't know who is the next person. But with history, we're going to liberate our people one after the other through history. Because when I'm meant to read and understand and research, I'm meant to understand that Biafra has been existing millions and thousands of years. You know, so I see some people telling me that Nigeria was created by God. I begin to laugh and I feel ashamed of myself when people tell me that Nigeria was created by God. We all know how Nigeria was created by the British company, British themselves, forming it from company to a country. So I believe our children, anywhere you are, anywhere you see your children, your friend that speaks Igbo, take time to teach them history. It's very, very important so that they will really know who they are. Many of us didn't witness Biafra War. But today, the thing is in our spirit. It's in our spirit. It's in our blood. So if the same will begin to tell it to our children, them too, they will understand the importance of Biafra. They will understand what we are fighting for. I bet you, and God will bless every Igbo brothers all over the world. All our Igbo brothers who stand for man, the camp, God will continue to bless you. And I continue to love those that are saying because of the election, that they should not bring them and the camp out, my brother. We have nothing against the election, but we are going to be watching them. Many of them will come back. After the election, I bet you, many of them will come back for Duduwa. Many of them will come back for Biafra people. Many of them will be begging for Nnamdi Kanu again. At that time, maybe the gate may be too close for to be shut down on them, but I don't know. But nobody should panic for tomorrow. Tomorrow's case is just, I would like to say, it's a laughter for me. So anything you can publish online, anything you can post online to make sure will be on the positive side. Thank you very much. In Jesus' name. Amen.
He say, Mazi, Mbosos, Ikucha, Ikuchuku, Kabiam, Edin, Chuku, Kabiam, where your Elohim will continue to be your strength. He say, you see, you make a very wonderful point here, of which I bet most of us know. I will still use this opportunity to remind our people. You see, when you go to Radio Biafra, Mazi Jonathan, more especially, this man is doing a very wonderful job. This man is liberating the mind of our people. This man is liberating the cycle of our people, washing it and turning it upside down, teaching our youth, those that have interest, to know how our ancestral heritage used to be. Because you see, the biggest problem we have is that most of our people don't know who we are. They don't know who they are. And believe me, as a Biafran, Nwafibu, the day you really know who you are, the day you cross paths with your chi, you will understand how powerful you are. You will understand how precious you are. You will understand how mighty you are. You will understand what kind of human being you are, that you are not an ordinary being. You can speak with authority, knowing fully well that life is about incarnation and not what the white people are telling us. May Chukwu Okabiama continue to bless you, Mazi. I want to call on Mazi, Captain. I think he's going to be our last speaker today. For those of you that didn't get the opportunity, I will beg you for next time. Mazi, Captain, comrade, are you ready to have the mic?
My lovely brother, Chukwu Okabiama Gozege.
Mazi, the floor is yours. The mic is yours. Thank you. You are welcome.
Our able host, the Biafran Twitter, our lovely comrades, everybody, Omo Biafra, the great IPOB family, one very big, large family, our sisters in the house, and all the speakers, I greet everybody. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you're speaking from. The illegal detention of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu against appeal court judgment. I'm just going to drop this little gem here, which is what you're seeing now is historical. And none of this can come in a platter of gold. It is not a bed of roses. For we to gain our freedom, we must patiently endure pain, just like Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is going through. if you look at what is happening in the world, you would realize that it is not ordinary. The enemies we see today who are enslaving us today are only but rounding themselves up in a box. You know, the current war going on opened a lot of wormholes. Everybody, I mean everybody who used to back these people up when they are oppressing us, the universe is about to keep them busy. And they will be so busy that when the time comes, when this so-called zoological republic will call them and say, hey, come, these people that you say you should be using gun and cane to keep at bay for you, they are rising up. Oh. Those people are going to tell them, we are busy with our own problems. Find a way and handle them yourself. And by the time they would finish with their own busyness and come back, we have gotten our freedom. You can only understand this if you're following the hands of time. Currently, there is flood in Nigeria. It is not ordinary. And currently, all of these things is happening. It is not ordinary. Britain is going to become busy. And this busy is going to come from an obstination. Yes, Chukwuka Abiyama is going to make their heart obstinate. And they are feeling the heat. A great protest is coming. A great rancor is coming. So when you look at what the zoo is doing, it's because they are also running out of time. They are running out of ideas. And at the latter part of the day, they will end up in the middle of nowhere. Why do I say so? Remember, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu said something. I will come to your courts and I will win you in your own courts. If you remember one of his broadcasts, he said, they don't respect the rule of law. And that is true. They don't respect the rule of law. So do you expect them to release Mazen Nnamdi Kanu just like that? No. But one thing I'm predicting that is going to happen is as good as this. Remember before when it happens, they have a place to go and buy their fighter jets, their old fighter jets. They are going to have a place where they go to buy their war machine, their weapons, their guns, and the rest of them. Now, even the same America is running out of weapons. Even the same Britain is running out of weapons. The same Europe is running out of weapons and the rest of them. They have a war to fight in order to keep the new world order that is actually in shambles. For a long time, I think it was since 1999 or so, is it in the 2000s that even Russia itself made Putin. Putin is going to be their president until the day he dies. China has renewed their president to be, for another third term. Now, what is the significance of this? There are some people who doesn't believe in the New World Order. So their current president, for example, the president of China, knows how to handle the West. The president of Russia knows how to handle the West. So there is this fight there. And this fight centers on all of these things that are happening. So they are going to hold Mazen Nnamdi Kanu and they will keep losing the court case. What is the significance of this? That at the latter part of the day, what happened in 1967 cannot be swept under the carpet, which is, what is the reason why you people went to war, or what is the reason why you committed this genocide against these people? You hear all the nonsense they say about Ojukwu. Now, if a civil war should break out now, and we say enough is enough, do you think they will have any claim to lay hold on the reason why they are coming for the second one? Or the reason why we ourselves, we decide to say, you know what, enough is enough, we are going to offensive, we are going to defend ourselves. Is there any reason for anybody to lay blames on us? The answer is no. So everything that you're seeing that is happening is historical. And as I repeated on the one of the spaces that we opened, I said this. For the first time in the history of this contraption, a man was willing to break the record of being the first black man not to be intimidated, who wasn't killed, but who fought, stood still, never betrayed his people, and stood to the test of time and to the sands of time. And that person remains Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. And I used Ken Saro Wiwa as an example. He didn't survive it. Not because he could not survive it, but because our oppressors, the colonial masters, they understand what it means to use our own to kill our own. But one man has broken that record. But because of the shenanigans of our people being meted with mental hardship, they don't want to get away from it. We are still in the same loophole. So at the latter part of the day, if I got that, waiting you read for book, not be waiting they go use, understand waiting they happen. I'm going to tell you the honest truth. We're going to go to court as 100 times as possible. We will always go and win. We will always go and win. But the last box stop is this. What is happening in Europe? What is happening in America? What is happening in Asia? This particular war is going to bring an end to something that we are not seeing that is coming. And what is that thing? The very fact that these tyrants are boxing themselves up. They will never tell you that they are losing. The same land that they are planning to grab and all of them now, suddenly one early morning, flood just came and covered the whole place. Please, I want to know, is it the same Obaru local government where they went to kill our people that is having flood today? Is it not the same Obaru that I saw the video today? Exactly. Is it not the same Benue State that they are killing people that flood is ravaged today? And so many other places. Until we understand what we are fighting, until we understand what is happening, until we understand that sometimes even me myself, I sit down and I see some visions that even I myself cannot explain, because I still cannot explain how something that has never been possible is possible in our time with Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. Nobody has ever won in that court, in that hydra-headed draconic court, where they use their incumbent power, where they pay themselves huge amount of money and nobody comes out from out of it. And this man was discharged and acquitted. And yet, they are angry about it that today, abi yesterday, they had to transfer the judges. And other judges are coming. Now, ask yourself one question. Who are the lawyers who defended them? Some of them were sons. Who came to defend Nigeria to make sure that... Because the whole game is to repeat what happened to Ken Saro. They want to judge him until they sentence him to death. But the funny part is that we are resolute. We are formidable. And like I said, Europe is just only suffering from power cuts.
The greatest protest is coming. And when that protest comes, I'm sorry, we have to gear up, but because we are about to receive the greatest order that every Biafrans have been waiting for. The other day, I saw a video of what happened in Alaba Market. And when I listened to the video, I was hearing Nzobu, Nzobu, Eyimba, Nzobu, Eyimba. I was hearing that those chants. And it's reminding me of what is coming. Biafrans are very, very angry. And it is sad. A lot of people here might not like it. That even our own leader might have to give the order from where he is. Maybe when he is going to say, the time is here, I am ready, take the cup away from me. And it is going to be what it is going to be. So we must mark history. And we must understand history from the deepest point. And for we to understand this history from the deepest point, you see the way we all stand together unitedly. That is how we must keep going. So, am I even worried about his illegal detention? I'm not worried. I'm the happiest person on earth. Because the guy, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, keeps breaking history upon history. Who are they laughing now? The same people holding him are the people they are laughing. So, to round up, history has been kind and fair to us. Whatever we choose to make out of history now depends on us. If we will allow a sycophant, a low-budget Zelensky from somewhere to come and then now begin to pinch us in the ass, if we want that to happen then, but all I know is that I and my household have come to understand how history is being kind to us. And we are going to take advantage of history and correct history. Whether they like it or not, Biafra is here and Biafra is here to stay. There is no going back. I yield the mic.
Thanks very much, Mazi Mechukwu Okabiam. Bless you. There is no retreat. There will be no surrender until Biafra land is completely restored and there is nothing anybody can do about it. You see what my comrade just said just now? I want to give you people a little bit insight of what we that are living here in the Western world are witnessing through these powers that are fighting themselves. For example, I work with Mercedes Company. The last weeks, we used to have 3-shift system. But due to this problem they are having with Russia, they are cutting the shift to 2. They are rationing the gas they have. They don't have much gas again because China and Russia smartly succeeded in holding them economically hostage. Russia was feeding them with very cheap gas. China was giving them very cheap workers. That means you can come to our country, build your factory, produced at a very cheap rate, and they all exported their company there in China and in Taiwan more especially. So, and right now, when it has come to this struggle, all Russia need to do is to stop giving them gas and the economy starts crumbling. Everything is getting expensive. That is what most people does not know. And this winter is going to be a very big problem for those of us that are living here in Europe. Normally, by this time last year, we are all allowed to turn on our heaters. But right now, there is no company or government houses in this Germany that is allowed to turn their heater except from the first week of November. And then from that first week of November, you are not allowed to turn the heater more than 19 degrees. Before you could turn it to 35 degrees, 40, it doesn't matter because you are the one paying. But because they are not, they don't have this secured gas supply anymore from Russia, they have to manage the gas they have. They are rationing everything. And we all know from what they prognize that with time, they have to decide which company can start, can keep running, and which company that cannot run again. Because already, due to the problem the Americans were having with the China, at the South China Sea, where Taiwan is located, the chips that they need to build most things here are not coming like the way it used to come, because China is blocking the sea. And now that Xi Jinping has been confirmed again as the leader of the Communist Party, wait for it, because that is why all this, why America has no choice. They cannot fight two wars at two fronts. They've kicked Russia out of a SWIFT transfer, this international transfer code, SWIFT. They didn't know that Russia and China have already built their own BRICS, another means of transferring money. They built their own MasterCard. Russian economy has tripled, you know, since the beginning of the war. Before, one euro is equal to 90 ruby. But today, 1 euro is just 30 rubies. So who is losing? They are not telling the other part of the world, you know, the third world countries, the realities we are facing here. In France, people are protesting. Even in Germany, where I am, the other weekend, you have more than 25,000 people protesting in Dresden and Leipzig, because there, the cost of living is too high. They are saying openly they are tired of this war with Russia, and they are asking their government to go and seek peace with Russia, because you can't bite a finger that is feeding you. And most European citizens have understood that this is not their war, that this is American war, and they don't want to have anything to do with it. Just like as my comrade said, the table is turning for us. This is our time, and nothing is going to stop it. And most of us, the hardcore IPOB members, knows that we are on a divine mandate. Our leader has a divine mandate to deliver. And until he gets to his destination, nothing is going to stop him, because the hands of Chukwuka Biama is with him. If it was possible for them to kill our leader, they should have killed him in Kenya. But it was impossible. Wherever he shows up, the sun starts shining. Wherever he shows up, the light keep brightening. And this is what they are all seeing. They will all be confused tomorrow. What they will witness tomorrow will be worse to whatever they've ever witnessed in the last days and in the coming days that is about to come in future. Freedom is our own. Freedom is assured. And there is nothing any living human being can do to stop it. We shall continue, because our fight, like as I used to say, our fight is to restore a Biafra where equal rights and justice for all citizens that live within our territory are guaranteed, where the life of a human being worth more than the life of a cow. We are fighting to restore a Biafra where free education for all will be guaranteed for the citizens living within our territory. Where free education shall be guaranteed for everyone living within Biafran territory. We are fighting to restore a Biafra where steady water supply shall be guaranteed for everybody. We are fighting for a Biafra where steady power supply shall be a common thing for every citizen of Biafra. Where secured social welfare shall be common within for our cities, within our territory. Anybody living within our territory should be able to receive money from the state, because we have the resources. In case most of you does not know, those of us living in this Western world, these countries we are living in, they have no natural resources. They are surviving on your back because of the resources they are taking, especially from our land. And most citizens here, they all have a bank card, this normal bank card from the state that they receive. You go and open an account, and every month ending, the government transfer money for you. Those of you that those that doesn't have roof under their head, the government provide it for them. These are the things, the amenities we enjoy here. And this is something most of us have known. We've gotten used to it through many years that we spend here. And this is what our dream, and this is what we know that is possible with the massive resources we have in Biafra land, that every Biafran citizen is supposed to enjoy such amenities. We have the people that we transform it. That's why our leader keeps saying in his broadcast, he came to restore Biafra, but he's not willing to rule Biafra because he knows that in Biafra land, you have a lot of heads, those that are qualified to do the job. People like Professor Emeka Akezuoha, a man that built this solar motorcycle in somewhere in Uganda. Such an engineer, such a scientist. You have a lot of them. You can keep counting. If you keep counting, the day will break and you can continue counting. So we are fighting to restore a Biafra where the pension fund is guaranteed for our old citizens that have worked all their life to make sure that our nation is moving. We are fighting to restore a Biafra where the government will support the young entrepreneurs because we have many young talents in Biafra land so that they can grow and create more jobs for our citizens. We are fighting to restore a Biafra where the government will support the existing industries like Innocent, many other industries you have in Biafra land that are producing that people are not hearing, so that they will be big enough to compete with the international, with the industries you have internationally in other countries of this Western world. We are fighting for Biafra where the government will make sure that we have very nice and modern infrastructure, better than Dubai and what you have like in Western world here. You see, those of us hardcore Biafran, there are songs we used to sing. We said, Enya Biafra, wanting to get. I am a Obulaleze Enigwe, because we are not part of those that the white man told that the heaven is there. You can look up, you will see heaven. While less they come here in Europe and turn it to heaven, and their people are living in it. If you tell a white man about church, he will point his hat to your head and tell you, you that is carrying church in your head, look at Africa, how you guys are suffering. Where is your God? It is only we that are fooling. This is our song each time we go on demo and process and protest. There will nothing will happen to our leader. Our leader shall come out with Biafran flag and lead us home. Children of the Most High Chukwuka Abiama, as we are coming to the end of the program today, I want to remind us one more time the topic of today's program. If you are related to one of these Eastern, so-called Eastern politicians, one of these so-called elites, remind them the clock are ticking, the time is running, they better speak up. Their silence is complicit to what is happening to our people. Their silence is complicit to killing going on in Biafran land. Their silence is complicit to the stealing, robbing, raping, plundering, massacring of Biafran citizens. Their silence to the persecution of our leader, Onyedumba Nnamdi-Kanu, is a direct indictment to each and every one of them. And we are keeping records. They shouldn't forget the French Revolution, because Biafran Revolution might be worse than French Revolution if they keep silent, if they continue. In French Revolution, the ordinary citizens took laws into their hand and got rid of their elite. And through that, France is what it is today. I still want to use this opportunity to beg each and every one of you to always tune in to Radio Biafra whenever Mazi Jonathan is preaching the gospel of Chukwuka Abiama, because Radio Biafra is our place of worship. Biafra remains our religion, our way of life. This is what Onyendu teaches us with discipline, and we should continue to be formidable. There is nothing anybody can do about it. We shall restore the holy land of Biafra, the kingdom of God on earth. And with this wonderful voice, I want to remind the youth of Biafrans that how long shall you stand and watch while our hero keep perishing in castration of DSS? We shall all fight to make sure we free our leader if need be. But we are lawful people, and we are good and disciplined, just like the way our leader asks us to be. And that's why tomorrow we shall be waiting for the judgment. And as we are waiting for the judgment, we shall be waiting for the signs from our leadership, because we know that the hours are coming close and close. And before I leave, I will leave with this music, because very soon I know that the hours is near where we shall march hand in hand, singing and dancing to the redemption song, the song of freedom. And there is nobody that can stop it. From me, from here, I want to thank the host one more time for giving us the opportunity to be here today. The same way I want to thank the HOD, Mazi Chike Doziem, our lead Onyendu Mazi Nnamdi-Kanu, wherever he is, that Chukwuka Abiama continue to be with him, protect and guide him. May he be his guidance. May he protect him and make sure that no harm befall him. The same way I want to thank the Dos. The Dos are wise men assembled by our leader to make sure that this structure of this holy struggle is secured, and are doing their work wonderful. May Chukwuka Abiama bless you all. And may Chukwuka Abiama bless every IPOB family members and all the principal officers, those that are sacrificing a lot that most of you are not seeing. I say may Chukwuka Abiama bless them and continue to guide and protect them. From me, from here, it is good night, and we shall see us next week, Sunday, the same time. With this music, I'm going to take a leave. May Chukwuka Abiama bless you all. He say.
All virus, yes, they run by. So into the merchant ships. Minutes after they're too kind. From the bottomless pit. But my air was missed wrong. By the end of the Almighty, we've powered in this generation. Triumphantly, won't you help the same? This sounds of freedom, that's all I ever had. Redemption song. Emancipate yourself from mental slavery. Number two, ourselves can free our mind. I've no fear for atomic energy, cause none of them can stop the time. Allah shall kill our prophets while we stand aside and look. Some say in just a part of it, we've got the book. Won't you guess the snare? These songs of freedom is all I ever had. We think